Did you ever find yourself frustrated again in front of a merge conflict? Ever thought to yourself, my God, this is a trivial one. I wish there was something to solve this obvious step for me. Well, check this out. There's a hidden feature in Git. This is the doc's words, not mine, that can magically solve merge conflicts. It's called Git rerere, and it stands for reuse recorded resolution, which in simple words mean solve the current conflict like I solved similar other ones before. The feature is off by default, so in this video, we're going to switch it on and see how to use it in real scenarios where conflicts can be resolved automatically for us. If you're now thinking every conflict is different, why would I even use this? Well, there are two main reasons. One that I actually try to avoid is long-living branches, where rerere helps with solving continuous merges so that when you eventually do merge the main branch, there's nothing to solve. The other, which is more relevant to my personal flow, is keeping a branch rebased with main, where I keep handling the same conflicts over and over because of ambiguity. And while there are other solutions to this like merge strategies, today we're focusing at this hidden functionality that can help both developers and maintainers constantly battling, merging or rebasing with conflicts. With that in mind, let's go. In order to enable rerere, we have to configure it. It usually goes into the global Git config, and after setting it up, we can confirm it was properly set. This can also be fetched with Git config by fetching rerere.enabled. What we're going to go through is a slightly improved version of the process you can take by reading the features docs on the main Git repository. Let's create a project to test on. So we make sure there's nothing either interrupting the example or is preconditioned in any way. I'm using Cargo to create a Rust project that by default has a Hello World app inside, just because it's easy and it's Rust, so why not? If I open main.rs, the app prints Hello World and can be built and run successfully. Let's make sure the Git repo is initialized and holds a first commit in the log since we're using the main branch. Once ready, I'll go ahead and branch out into the very original name, another branch, where I'm going to change hello to hola because Rust isn't enough, so I want to practice my Espanol as well. I'll commit the changes, and yes, the interface is NeoGit. Link to the video covering NeoGit is up here. Let's go back to the original branch from which we're branching out yet again into another super original name, yet another branch. In alignment with the example from the docs, I'm going to change world to mundo and commit the change with NeoGit. Okay, here's the deal. Now we have master branch holding hello world, we have another branch holding hola world, and yet another branch holding hello mundo. What could possibly go wrong, right? Let's go back to the first branch where I still hold my first commit with hello world. I'll start by merging another branch, which goes okay. Main RS now has hola world. Cool. Now let's merge yet another branch, and here we go. A merge conflict. But you may have noticed something different about this conflict. It says recorded pre-image for src main.rs. We'll touch later on what a pre-image is and what it looks like, but Git is recording something about this conflict. Yes, of course, this is thanks to rerere being enabled. Now the same feature also stands on its own. Now that we're in active merge conflicts, Git rerere status shows the file in question. We can also call the same with diff to visually print the conflict itself. And unsurprisingly, hello mundo and hello world are conflicting with each other. If we open main.rs, the conflict is clear. And while we have a few methods to solve this, today we're going raw to understand the basics. I'll show you a cooler way to solve merge conflicts at the end, so stick around. But for now, let's just set the line to hola mundo and resolve the issue. All that's left is to stage the file and commit to let Git know we're ready. Now, here's the cool part. Git says recorded a resolution for src main.rs. Meaning it now has a recollection of how a certain conflict was resolved, and if it sees something similar in the future, it'll hopefully know how to handle it. Machine learning, right? Let's put its name to the test. Reset to head with caret, by the way, takes us one commit back, so we're at hola world again. Let's switch to the third branch with hello mundo and try to rebase the change. We'll rebase master on the branch, and while as expected the process fails over a conflict, catch this. Git has resolved main.rs using previous resolution. Yep, the recorded resolution earlier served as memory and the same issue popped on a different process, but rerere already knew the scenario and handles it automatically. Git magic. If we run diff, it's beautifully shown how hola world and hello mundo automatically rewritten as hola mundo by Git on its own. Why did the merge fail, you ask? Well, Git doesn't take full ownership over your code, and while it did solve the issue on paper, you have to be the one reviewing and committing it as you're the author. Here's another way to use rerere and see it in action. Did you know you can check out a conflict? With checkout conflict and merge main.rs, Git recreates the merge conflict so we can look at it just like any other commit in the tree. So now, with the conflict back in place, we can resolve it with Git rerere and see the same resolution report. Kinda cool, isn't it? Git status still says we're in rebase, as you have seen in my prompt earlier. This, by the way, is Starship, also written in Rust, and there's a video all about Starship right up here. So with that, let's move on. Let's stage the file and continue the rebase process. Small commit with the changes in place and we're done. Just to see that no tricks were made, I'll go back to master and merge the earlier problematic branch, which now goes through with no problems at all. If we pop the log, it's straight as an arrow. First commit, hola world and hola mundo, as if nothing happened. If you're ever in doubt, the help pages for Git rerere are your friend, but honestly, most of it is done for you, and as long as you remember the basics, you're good to go. To see what rerere is doing under the hood, let's take a look inside .git, where you'll find a new rr-cache for recorded resolution cache as a subdirectory holding different objects. Since we only have one change recorded, we only have one hashed resolution, and if we take a peek inside, it holds what we've seen earlier: a pre-image, a post-image, and this image. These are just recorded conflicts and the resolution. Git holds the pre-image as the predefined status. In this case, hello mundo conflict. Then there's this image for a current state to match. And finally, the post image is what rerere would use in order to solve the matched conflict. All of a sudden, it doesn't seem like pure magic, but just a hell of a useful feature within Git no one had ever heard of. It's not far-fetched to assume we'll soon have an AI model serving the same purpose.
Don't worry, I got your conflicts covered.
But for the time being, you have to admit this is pretty awesome, especially for those who rebase often like me, annoyed by the repeating conflicts. I promised a cool merge conflict resolution with Vim, so check this one out. I'll quickly recreate another issue by adding a comment. On one branch, it's going to say something, and on the other, I'll say something else, for the sake of simplicity. Once both committed, I'll go back to the original branch and create the same issue as earlier. With the conflict in place, let me open main.rs and zoom out a little bit so you can see the next trick. GV diff split, V stands for vertical by the way, leaving it out will split horizontally. This opens a three-way diff merge. What we're seeing here are three buffers. The centerpiece is my current conflict, whereas the left and right are two options. We can pop telescope to see the buffers, and you can always find the left option with a /2 in its name, whereas the other buffer has /3. This is good for binding shortcuts, picking one side or the other if you want to bake this into your normal flow. To pick one, we can diff get and tab lets me pick a buffer. Let's go with 3, which has something else, and the pick is injected as a resolution. All that's left is a quick commit and we're done. The tree will show a branched out change that's merged back. Let's not forget that this is a very simple conflict, and this method becomes way more powerful when a conflict is more complex and requires different pickers to resolve everything. As you've seen, sometimes your conflicts aren't trivial and repeating them is simply not an option. If you want to dive deeper into three-way conflict resolution in Vim, go ahead and watch the full video covering it. And if you still don't have Git integrated into your development environment, then you should probably start with this video covering all the plugins and configurations, making Vim or NeoVim the perfect frictionless environment. Thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next one.